Welcome to the Awaken Beauty Podcast. Now, we all know that stress can have a very detrimental impact on our mental health. And today we're going to crack open how stress affects our health and how this then rolls over into our outer beauty. So essentially, how it accelerates aging, where and how. So long-term stress can eventually become chronic, and it leads to depression, anxiety, and fatigue. Depression is a serious mental health condition that can cause you to have negative feelings towards all aspects of your life. And losing interest in things you used to enjoy, like feelings of hopelessness or suicidal thoughts, are common symptoms of severe depression, and you need help. But how does it affect our physiological stress and our body? And so it's very widely studied that stress hormone corticosteroid suppresses the immune function that is also our infection-fighting white blood cell ability to go after all of these immune modulators and downgrade them. So it's important to notice that stressful times that we're prone to, like getting stuffy nose or adrenal fatigue, is the body's response to stress long term. And so when we're triggered in this fight or flight response, it causes the heart to beat faster, our blood pressure to rise, and it's constantly putting us into this internal state of overload. And it severely heightens our chances of cardiovascular disease. And high levels of stress are also known to have damaging effects on, yes, our hair and our skin as well. So how does stress affect our skin? So let's first talk about acne. And there are a few reasons why you might notice that the breakouts on your skin, whether it's from a form of acne, psoriasis, or eczema, the release of the stress hormone cortisol throws your body's hormones off balance, causing imperfections in your skin. And stress can also affect your gut health by outweighing the good and bad bacteria that sits within it. So uneven bacteria can cause also these rashes and unwanted pimples. So there's the added factor of diet when you're experiencing stress. And when you're working long hours, or it's just you're just in general stressed out with work or relationships, drinking energy drinks or drinking coffee, dietary choices are going to show up for sure within pimples and exasperate skin conditions. How about under eye circles? So these under eye bags are far from ideal, and they make you look tired and sick, and there's just not enough concealer to go around to cover them up. So when you're experiencing stress, there's a high chance that you're also missing sleep. And sleep deprivation results in higher levels of cortisol itself. So it antagonizes the body even more to create these dark circles. So the bags under the eye are caused by this pooling fluid around the under eye that is best to fix them by simply getting sleep, de-stressing your lifestyle. You can also apply serums, and this can also improve the under eye bags. So I love Evoke lip and eye cream because it encourages the skin renewal to reduce the inflammation and the stagnation and tighten and hydrate the skin underneath the eye. So the dark eye circles, when we're stressed, can actually be very, very fragile and vulnerable capillaries underneath your eye. And the blood leaks in the epidermis and they become oxidized, which results in that really dark pigment and the discoloration underneath the eye. And that's what gives it that specific appearance. Now, not only is this but your body's way of dealing with stress, but blood will be distributed to different areas, more important for the body, which does not include the face and skin or hair. So the more stress that your body is under, the more likely you are to look pale and drained as the blood is focused on your organs, making sure that you are working effectively. So this in turn then makes the appearance of those dark circles even more noticeable underneath the eyes. So how about fine lines? So when we're stressed, our body can react in all different kinds of ways, which we've already discussed. And we feel like we're emotional, we may lose our appetite, we may have mood swings, or again, it affects our sleep. So the difficulty to function throughout the day actually affects the fine lines and the wrinkles on the skin because the body is again producing more cortisol. And this stress hormone has been known to break down collagen in your skin. And if you're stressed more, the more that hormone of cortisol is going to be risen, it's going to attack your skin and cause degeneration in the skin. So with the lack of sleep, you will begin to show signs of fatigue. And all of these fine lines and wrinkles are a direct consequence of elasticity. And so dehydration can be dangerous for your inner organs as well as your skin if you're not staying hydrated and de-stressed, because hydration is the body's number one way to produce collagen to make your skin look youthful and plump. And without it, wrinkles and fine lines are absolutely visible and your skin just thins out and starts to sag. So if you're looking dry and flaky, you're going to want to use a moisturizer outside and stay hydrated to effectively address dry skin. Now, our Youth Renewal and Pro Collagen Cream is a full face program and ritual that will help both of these factors. So how does it affect then your hair health? So stress has been linked to hair loss and thinning, but the causes could differ. The same way that stress can damage the appearance and the feel of your skin, it can also be the same for hair. It could be genetic and it could be environmental. So let's talk hair loss. So the three stages of hair growth process is the anagen phase, the catagen phase, and the telogen phase, which is the last phase. And stress can trigger what's known as the telogen, which occurs when the hair growth cycle stops at that end stage and the follicles don't grow any new hair. So the telogen is a reversible condition, but it's a temporary disturbance cycle, which changes when your lifestyle changes or your health changes. So alopecia is basically an immune system attack on the hair follicles, causing the patches to fall out over time or all at once. So it's often really actually associated with experiencing high levels of stress and an extended period of time. It weakens the immune system, just like our skin. So you really need to lower your stress levels if you want to experience less hair loss as well. So if you're experiencing hair thinning, trying our powerful Root Revival Hair Program, it's proven with growth actives that strengthen the hair, and it also encourages the cellular turnover for new hairs to grow. It's so powerful that it's 2 times more powerful than minoxidil. So how about gray hair? So science backs up the saying that stress can actually turn your hair gray. So is it a myth? So when you're experiencing high stress levels, the struggle to produce pigmentation called melanin, which keeps your hair color the natural color that it is, experiencing stress over long times and periods of time, it brings an imbalance to the hormone, which is melanin, and it produces stem cells in the body. So if you're not producing the stem cells and the melanin and the cortisol is rising again in long extended periods of stress, the body is going to other areas to create efficiency to keep you healthy versus bringing the hormonal and the mitochondrial production of the form of melanin. So you can see here, we've just done a deep dive on how stress can affect our hydration levels, which then affects loose and wrinkly and fine lines. It also addresses the production of collagen and how stress takes away the production of collagen, which is essential for aging and bouncing, beautiful, glowy skin. We also talked about hair loss and how stress can, again, your hair and your skin is the last point of reserve, and our skin and our hair need just as much, if not more, nutrients than, they need the essential cofactors to be able to produce and keep producing. And so, there are just so many layers and effects of stress. And I believe that within the next gen of health and beauty, we really are a whole person. And I am addressing within Evoke Beauty and Beauty Ecology Organic Salon. And I address stress in a couple different ways. I address it by hypnotherapy. So up-leveling the way we think, the way our mind works through subconscious mind, reprogramming for the better, as well as biofeedback, which is the next generation way of how we can address our energetic health. So we are all energy, and energy is everything. And the biophotons, we are waves and forms of energy. And if we're not getting to the very, very bottom root of our energetic health, in which is before things turn physiological, then that is where I believe that is the root, actual root. Now, I've studied functional medicine for years, but I'm now going back down to the energetic. And our biofield is the essence of our health, emotionally, mentally, spiritually, and physically. And this also applies to our hair and our skin and our outer beauty. Because if we're energetically taking care of ourselves through biofeedback is my ways of means of doing that, and through hypnotherapy, so that we're really getting the unseen things uncovered and really nurtured, as well as the topical through clean and pure beauty and supplements through CBD or anything like that. Being proactive with those two modalities, to me, I know is the way of the future. So if you have any questions about Evoke Beauty, you can go to evokebeauty.com, evokebeauty.com. If you're interested in my biofeedback services, it is pretty much the easiest thing that you can automate for your health. They are personalized healing tones that I specifically formulate for you based on the key stressors that are going on for you every single week through the month. So there you have it. Thank you for following the Awaken Beauty podcast. I hope you enjoyed this mini episode. Please reach out if you have any questions about products, energy, how your mind works, and how this all actually is the root of true, true longevity and healthy aging. All right. That's it for now. Thank you again. Bye-bye.